Polish notations, in which we'll see the different three notations: Polish notation, that is infix notation, prefix notation, and postfix notation. The learning outcome: student can comprehend Polish notations. Student will be able to recognize different types of Polish notations. The content of the today's topics are statement, notations, type of Polish notations, infix, prefix, and postfix. The definition: all the declarative sentences to which possible to assign one or only one two possible truth values, either true or false. For example, India is a country, Delhi is capital of Maharashtra. This statement is false. These are the three statements we have considered. Out of that, the first statement, India is country, has got the true value. Second, Delhi is the capital of Maharashtra, which has got the false value. Whereas the third one, we cannot assign either true or false value. So, according to our definition, it cannot be a statement. How to symbolize all these simple statements. For example, consider Ram went to school. This can be symbolized with any alphabet, say R. You can take A to Z, out of that I have taken R. The second statement, consider Shyam went to the playground. Now in this, Shyam went to the playground, you can consider, say yes. Now if I combine these two statements, like Ram went to the school and Shyam went to the playground, this is called as a compound statement. And the simple statements are like Ram went to the school is a simple statement, Shyam went to the playground is a simple statement. When you combine these two simple statements, that becomes a compound statement, and it can be written as Ram went to the school and Shyam went to the playground. This can be symbolized with a connective called as a AND. This AND is a operator, logical operator, AND is used. So this can be symbolized as R and S, which is statement formula. This formula can be represented as in Polish notations. This Polish notation is called as an infix notation. As I told in the first slide, there are three types of notations: infix, prefix, and postfix. Let us see one by one. Infix notations, how they are represented? They are represented like this: operand 1 followed by operator followed by the operand 2. Now what is operator? Operators are plus, minus, multiplication, division. These are the arithmetic operators. Then logical operators like AND, OR, conditional, biconditional, NAND, NOR, XOR, all these are the operators. So whenever we write operator between two operands, that is called as a infix notation. So operators are written in between their operands. This is the usual way we write expression. An expression such as, consider this expression which is written in brackets, A multiplied by into bracket B plus C, bracket closed, divided by D, which is usual writing expression using plus, multiplication, and division. Now here, how this expression is evaluated means what is the priority of the expression. Now in mathematical expression, first of all, multiplication and divisions are evaluated first, then plus and division, plus and minus are evaluated. Out of that, the innermost, if suppose brackets are there, the innermost bracket will be evaluated first. So in this example, we observe that B plus C is the innermost bracket. So B plus C will be evaluated. So first of all, add B and C together. That is, B plus C will be evaluated. The result of that is multiplied with A. That is, A multiplied by result of B plus C. then the result of this entire bracket is divided by D. This is how the expression is evaluated. Now, prefix notation. If you look at this, plus xy, this indicates that plus is an operator followed by the two operands x and y. Means in this case, first of all, operator followed by the two operands. In infixed, first operand 1, operator followed, then lastly operand 2. But in the prefix, it is first of all operator followed by the two operands. Operators are written before their operands. Now the same expression, a into b plus c divided by d can be written in prefix like this. First of all, divide, multiplication, a plus b, c and d. As the, for the postfix operators, left to right and brackets are superplus operators act on the two nearest values on the right. We have again added totally unnecessary brackets, means saying that plus BC is evaluated first, then result of that will be evaluated with A with a multiplication, and result of this will be with D by the division operation. Now the prefix notation in the example given in the previous slide, although the division is the first operator on the left side, it acts on the result of the multiplication, and so the multiplication has to happen before the division, and similarly the addition has to happen before the multiplication because they are stored in the brackets, because postfix operators use values to their left. Any values involving computations will already have been calculated, and we go left to right, and so the order of evaluation of the operators is not disrupted in the way as the prefix expression. Postfix notations. It is also known as a reverse Polish notation, and it is denoted as xy plus, indicating that x, y are the operands, operand 1, operand 2, x is operand 1, y is operand 2, and followed by the operator plus. Operators are written after the operands. The infix expression given above is equivalent to ABC plus multiplication division D division. Now operators act on the values immediately to the left of them. For example, the plus above uses the B and C. We can add totally unnecessarily brackets to make the explicit, like BC plus first of all, then followed by the result of that with a multiplication with A, and the result of A multiplied by BC plus divided by D. Thus the multiplication uses the two values immediately preceding A and the result of the addition. Similarly, the division uses the result of the multiplication of D. Take a minute and write the following statement into infix notations. Now, Ram is playing football and Sham is watching the television. Now, this is a compound statement. Now, what are the simple statement? The first simple statement is Ram is playing the football. And the second statement is Sham is watching the television. These are the two statements connected by this AND, A-N-D, AND. Let us take a minute and solve this. The answer, this can be symbolized. Ram playing football can be symbolized, say, with R. Sam is watching the television with, say, S. Ram is playing football and Sam is watching the television. This can be symbolized with R and S, which is called as a infix notation. The same can be written in prefix is called as a AND RS, and same can be written as in postfix is RS AND. Take a note, in all three versions the operands occur in the same order and just the operators have to move to keep the meaning correct. This is particularly important for the asymmetric operators like subtraction and division. A minus B does not mean that the same as B minus A. the former is equivalent to AB minus or minus AB in case of prefix, the latter to BA minus or minus BA. The BA minus is postfix and this minus BA is a prefix. These are the some infix, postfix and prefix notations. Let us consider the first one, A into B plus C divided by D. Multiply A and B, divide C by D, add the results. The same thing in postfix, it is written as AB multiplication CD slash plus, in prefix plus A, B, division C, D. This is how the remaining expressions are encountered. These are the references. I hope you understood the polished notations. Thank you.